Welcome to the ET197 Ohmmeter Challenge Troubleshooting 3. Okay, I'm in the Ohmmeter Challenges and we're going to go to Troubleshooting 3. This one has a relay, which makes it good for 197. So we got a switch, relay, and some other things and a diode. So we'll go ahead and explore how diodes work, how an inductor works under a DC circuit. So, and we have two different types of contacts. We have a normally open contact, normally closed. So normally open is going to be an open circuit if it's working properly. A normally closed should have continuity through it if it's working. Okay, let's get started. So we have brown, red, black, 1, 2, 0. So 12 ohms, that's good. Our inductor is basically just a coil of wires, so it's going to be a very low resistance. Let's go ahead and check and see if we have continuity through our contact, and we do. And let's go ahead and see if we have a combination. So we have 12 and 16, which is right around 28, so that's good. Let's check our switch. 15, that's a little on the low side, but that's okay. So let's go check our diode. Let's go through our contact here. Okay, so we have infinite ohms. That means we've got an open. So let's check our diode. And our diode's good. Okay. So he looks okay to me. Good. 13, so we've got 1, 2, 0, 12 plus an inductor. That's fairly reasonable. Let's check and see. We have the resistance of a resistor and none of our coil. So our coil is shorted. Relay coil shorted. Okay, oops, that's not a good sign. So we have an open. We just need to figure out where that opens from. So let's check this guy. Oop, that's also open. So I'm going to say that our resistor is open. Good. We have 20 ohms, 2, 0, 0, 0 is good, 20 ohms. Let's check our relay, 56, 37, and 20 sounds good. Okay, since we're up here, let's check our switch. Oops, that means our switch is open, always open. Good. Okay, 20, we got a 20 resistor. We've got a 59, that looks reasonable, 20 and 39. Let's check our switch. Good. All right, everything, okay, let's check our relay here, our contact. Let's open him up. Very good. Now let's check our diode. Oops, infinite ohms, diode test. We got an open diode. Okay, we've got 1, 0, 0, 0. So it's about 10 ohms. That's reasonable. Let's check our relay. And we got 36 and 10, close enough. Let's check our, we got our resistance value, a resistor value, that's good. So our, oh, that is not good. That means our contact is shorted. We shouldn't get any continuity, that's an open contact. So we've got a shorted defective relay contact. Okay, oops, we have infinite, we have an open. Let's figure out what's open. Okay, so we got 10 and 17, that's good. So our open appears to be, let's check and see if our, that's good. I'm going to say that our inductor is open. Open inductor. Good. Oops, another bad one. Okay, so let's check this one. So we got 49, which is 12 plus 37. Perfect. And let's check our contact. That's good. It's open. Just for grins, let's check our switch. I know where it's at, but let's check our switch. Good. We have an open inductor. Let's go ahead and confirm that again. Oh, that is not the case. What happened here? That's reasonable resistance. Let's check our diode. And we have a low resistance. That means our diode shorted. Okay, 22. Good inductor. Let's check our relay. Oh, man. So, let's go ahead and check and see if we get anything through our switch. Nope, it's our relay that is open. Open relay coil. Good. 12, 1, 2, 0, that is 12. Check our coil. It's 11. No good. All right, let's see what we got going through our switch. That's shorted. So our relay is shorted. Shorted relay coil. Good. And we're done.